Laparoscopic dissection techniques. It is one of the very important skill which the surgeon should develop. It was said by Hippocrates that heat cures when everything fails. In old time, heat was one of the most important modality of healing in the medical science. Because there was no laparoscopy, there was no open surgery either, and there was no modern antibiotics, so heat was the most common mode of healing. Still today, we use heat, and if you have a backache or anything, your mother comes with the hot fomentation and you will feel better. When Thomas Edison has invented electric bulb, then there was a modified electric bulb with the tubular projection which was introduced into the anus and switching light on to treat the fistula, fissure or piles by heat of electric bulb. And we can consider it as an endoscopic technique because it was going through the natural orifices of the body. Mode of electric dissection, you use seizures also, cold seizures. But cold seizures has a risk that the structure which we are considering innocent might have bleeded. Yesterday you saw that I cut with the cold seizures, thinking that this is a band, and there was a bleeder. You can use platelet, peanut. Peanut has an advantage that it will not cut the bleeder, and it will strip only the peritoneum or adhesion, and it will swab the blood also. This is called as platelet dissection. Then you can use knife, you can use the blunt dissection with the instrument, like suction irrigation is the best instrument to do blunt dissection. But electrosurgery is the most convenient way of dissection in minimal access surgery. But unfortunately, it is the most risky method of dissection also. And complication rate is 1 to 2%. One of the most common cause of complication during the electrosurgery is use of energy. 1 to 2% complication rate is there. There are many cases, many cases. Hundreds of cases are there. If I will open the internet and I will start showing you the cases which is in my knowledge, it will take 1 hour time. Recently, one of the surgeons who was the Dharmender Garg, one Indian surgeon, he was very famous and from Punjab and America, he was known to everyone. And he was performing all the advanced surgery there in America. And one day, he was performing hernia surgery. I don't know what keyboard they have put there. And while performing hernia surgery, Mr. Pida hernia did. Here, Andrew Pira, he is a surgeon, he is a patient, and he was a healthy person, and he was operated for hernia surgery, and after surgery, after 2 days, he developed bowel palpitation, and after 2 days, he was again re-operated, and then ultimately died by Dr. Dharmender Garg. And unfortunately, this doctor has told to the court that I don't see also. The court heard Mr. Pira's sword, pathologist, and then other. And ultimately, it was a case of direct coupling. And it was a small bowel perforation. As you know, a small bowel perforation is one of the most common cause of injury. So this is not one. There are hundreds, which is in my knowledge. And this all happens because of energy. Energy is one of the big issues which you should keep in mind. The complication rate is 1 to 2%, means in 100%, 2% has energy injury. Before going in detail of electrosurgery, we should recall the principle of electricity. Already you know current means flow of electron. Circuit means pathway of flow of electron. Voltage means force that causes electron to flow. And resistance means obstacle to the flow of electron. There are two terms. One is electrosurgery and another is electrocautery. Electrocautery term is very popular. This is electrocautery. But this is wrong. Cautery machine has stopped manufacturing. The last manufacturing cautery machine was in year 2000. After that, no company is making cautery. Cautery was using a direct current. And there was a high resistance metallic conductor. The tip of the instrument was having one metallic conductor. This metallic conductor was red hot. And when you will touch any tissue by this red hot conductor, there will be arc and it will burn. And it is essentially application of heat. That was cautery. The machine which we use today is electrosurgical generator. And your instrument is not specialized. You can attach this electrosurgery in any instrument you want. You can attach in grasper, attach in needle, attach in the hook, attach in the Maryland, attach in the seizures. Your instruments are not specialized. And your instruments are never heated. Instrument doesn't have any heat. Once the electron of alternating current jump to the tissue, then inside the tissue there is a turbulence and that produces energy. Do you know, inside the cell there are ions, positive and negative ions. And due to alternating current there is a vibration inside and heat is produced within the cell. In electrocautery, direct current was used. In electrosurgery, alternating current is used. Alternating current is, this is our household appliances are using the alternating current. And direct current is using your mobile phone, your car. It has a DC, direct battery. So direct current is producing another technique of heat because of tip of the instrument was of made up of platinum and it is a high resistance conductor. But in electrosurgery we use high frequency alternating current. And this alternating current, once it enters into the tissue, alternating current means what? Every second, 50 to 60 times positive is becoming alternate negative is becoming positive. So due to positive negative, there is a vibration of the ions inside the cell. And due to that, heat is produced within the cell. And that heat go to our instrument. So instrument is not heated. Tissue get heated and that heat instrument is receiving. So it is completely different. In old time, after applying cautery, people were putting saline to make it cold. Immediately, if instrument will touch somewhere, it can burn. Today, not necessary. Because your instrument is always colder than the tissue. And as soon as you remove the instrument, you can catch the other tissue, it won't burn. So this is a completely different technology of electrocautery and electrosurgery. Cautery is no more available, you should not talk about cautery. Cautery, if you are talking, that means you don't understand. And in machine, it is never written cautery, it is written electrosurgical generator. But it is misnomer. We say cautery, switch on the cautery, give me cautery, I am using cautery. But it is wrong. This is the principle of electrosurgery. You have a generator, and through generator one wire will come. This wire you will attach in any instrument you can attach. You can attach in scissors, you can attach in grasper, you can attach in Maryland, and then you will touch the body of the patient. Once you touch the body of the patient, entire body of the patient will get current. Entire body of the patient. And it want to get out. It want to exit. And to exit, you are attaching patient return plate. That is called as return electrode. This return electrode will take, and then it will go to the machine again. It will go to the generator again. Return electrode will go to generator again. And that way, complete circuit is there. Now, unfortunately, if there is any alternative pathway is present, current will start traveling through that alternative pathway. Like if the patient thigh is touching the table, arm is touching the patient's arm rest. If patient is wearing some ornaments, the rings, the bangles, the necklaces, and those ornaments are touching somewhere in the middle part of the table, patient will get burned there also. This is a big headache. And it can create a lot of injury, a lot of injury. So the question is that how to solve the problem and why we are using it, why to use it. We should stop using the electrosurgery. It is useless. And which frequency is safe? This is the ideal frequency which you should use. 500 kilohertz to 3.3 megahertz. This is the frequency which is allocated for the electrosurgery. What is frequency? Frequency is hertz. Hertz is the unit of frequency. What is your household appliances frequency? 50 to 60 hertz. This is the frequency of our household appliances. Household appliances. This fridge, this AC, this projector, this all is working at 50 to 60 hertz. Why? Because at this frequency, our muscle and nerve is maximally stimulated. So we get electric shock. And our government wants that their citizens should get electric shock. Maximum electric shock they should get. Why? Because electric shock is good. Electric shock prevents us from a big electric burn. If this mic has a current, I will touch it, I will shout. Immediately my muscle contracts and my whole body will get energized. And I will, maybe if it is very high voltage, I will be thrown away. I can break my bone, but I can protect my life. Why electric shock is generated at 50 to 60 hertz? Because there is a burst of action potential. If you remember physics second year, for any nerve and muscle electrical conduction, there should be action potential. Action potential means permeability of the ion through the cell membrane. Inside, potassium is more, outside chloride is more. When outside is negative, it is pulling the potassium out, pushing the chloride in. And outside is positive, it will pull the chloride out and push the potassium in. And due to this alternating current, positive, negative, potassium chloride is exchanging through the cell membrane so fast that there is a burst of action potential. Our spinal cord, skeletal muscle, brain, everything get excited. And that our brain is receiving as a electric shock. This is what we feel as an electric shock. That is a burst of action potential due to the massive exchange of the ion through the cell membrane, creating an electrical current through the permeability of the ion flowing through our all the nervous system of the body is called as shock. But if frequency is more than 100 kilohertz, then there is no more electric shock. 100 kilohertz, there is no more electric shock. Question is why? 100 kilohertz means what? 100,000 hertz. 100,000 hertz means 1 lakh hertz. At 100,000 hertz, there is no electric shock. Why? Because frequency is changing so fast that there is no time for ion to exchange the cell membrane. When outside is positive and chloride started moving out, that is negative. Again it is pushed back, again positive. So ions are confused, I don't know where to go. When I am just about to move, it is again pushing me back. So there is only vibration, there is no movement. Just like if I hold the arm of someone and do like that, he will only vibrate, he cannot go either this side or that side. So there is no electric shock. Absolutely, burn will be there, but no electric shock. If you will increase the further, if you will go to 500 kilohertz to 3.3 megahertz, it is good for everything. For HA node, for Purkinje fibers, for our cardiac muscle, blood, lymph, gray matter of the brain, spinal cord, all is safe. This is the ideal frequency which is allocated for the electrosurgery. 500 kilohertz to 3.3 megahertz. If you use more than 3.3, then TV signals will produce. And it will not do any change. It will cross the body without affecting any of the movement. So high is also not good, low is also not good. But less than 100 is absolutely bad. It is absolutely not good. Less than 100. This side is absolutely wrong. This side is okay. Unfortunately, some of the instrument company of the world, Chinese and some poorly designed, engineered Indian company, they make an electrosurgical generator very cheap. You will be surprised. You can buy an electrosurgical generator for $100 to $200. It is available in the market. $100 to $200, and you buy it, and you use it, it works. But what will be the problem you will have? That it will create the sum of the lower frequency, sum of the frequency lower. So every time you use these electrosurgical generator, patient finger, foot, arm is twitching, calf is twitching, and arm of the patient will jerk. And do you know what we are doing? We are actually torturing our patient. Every time you are using that type of electrosurgery, unconsciously patient is getting electric shock. And patient is crying from inside. If you see after 10 minutes, tear is coming from the eye. It is a stage of amnesia. Anesthesia is a stage of amnesia. But still patient has feeling. Painkiller can create a good thing about pain relief. But painkiller will never relieve the shock. Patient muscle is paralyzed, otherwise he would have slapped you. What is this idiot doctor? You are punishing me. Electric shock you are giving every time to me. I have come for surgery or to take your shock. But patient is paralyzed muscles. He cannot do that. A study was performed in Clermont-Ferrand University. What they did, they used the electrosurgery, harmonic and plasma kinetic. And they studied the post-operative recovery. The patient who were operated with the low frequency electrosurgery post-operatively their recovery was delayed. Post-operatively their muscles were fatigued and they looked like sick. Their face was tired. The same patient who is performed with the plasma kinetic energy or harmonic, post-operatively they were fresh. Their face was energetic, smiling. The reason being, throughout the surgery of low-frequency electrosurgery, you are torturing your patient. You are giving electric shock. And you can understand, for 1 hour, if anybody will keep you giving electric shock, what will be your condition? If I have to get operated, first thing I will see which energy he is using. If he doesn't have his energy, please, I will not go for surgery. And you should also. God bless you, you should never get any surgery in your life. But if you have, then you must see the what machine you are using. So this is a cruelty. Now it's 500 to 3.3 megahertz is a big range. Which one you should use? It depends upon how much money is your in pocket. If you have less money, you will buy 500 kilohertz, 100 to 500 kilohertz machine. This is costing you $1,000. $1,000 is a good amount of money, but it is for electrosurgery minimum amount of money. $1,000 you will give, you will get it. If you have little more money, the approximately $5,000, you will get a radio frequency energy. This radio frequency energy is from 1 megahertz around. And it doesn't mean that once you use this machine, you will get a radio song. It is called radio frequency because at the same frequency, radio stations are working. In the morning, when you put All India Radio, first time in the morning, early morning, you switch it on, you know what they speak first sentence? Good morning, this is All India Radio at 1.1 megahertz frequency. Isn't it? 1.1 megahertz frequency. This is a frequency which is producing radio waves. So that's why it is called radio frequency energy. And if you use further high, then you can get a PK energy, that is plasma kinetic energy. There are many high-frequency generators which is available in the market. One is PK Gyrus. This is PK Gyrus. PK Gyrus is one of the very good energy from Olympus. And that is a plasma kinetic technology. It will be expensive to you, but you can buy it. This is PK Gyrus. And it's a very smart energy source. Another is Arbi. This Arbi generator. Is also very good German company. That also produces a very high frequency. This is Arbi. This is also using PK energy. It is fantastic, but problem is cost is 25 lakh rupees. That's why in India, this is Valley Lab. Valley Lab is, I am coming to Valley Lab, but Arbi is very good. Now another high frequency energy is force triad. This is force triad. Force triad from Covidian. This is also a very high frequency energy. This is Covidian Force Triad. Covidian and Valley Lab is same company. This is Force Triad. Why it is called triad? Because it has all the three, monopolar, bipolar, with PK and Valley Lab, this Ligasure also, inbuilt. This will also cost you approximately 15 to 16 lakh rupees. So if you have a good amount of money, then go for high frequency generator. So Question is, why should I use high frequency generator? If it is more than 100, my problem is solved, because it will not give electric shock to the patient. Then why should I spend that much money? Reason is, more the frequency you will buy, less wattage you have to use. And you will get same effect. In old time, when our soldiers were fighting with the sword, when there was no fight, they were whole day sharpening their sword. Because sharper the sword, less force will be required to cut. And the king having the best sword. People were presenting the best sword to king, because king is not six-pack. King is normal person with a lot of perversion. So he don't have a time to do exercises. So they were giving the sharp sword so that he can cut the head of the enemy easily without much force. So if you use sharper high frequency, if you have to do ovarian drilling, in electrosurgery you need 40 watt. If you use your radio frequency, you need only 10 watt. And if you use PK energy, you need 5 watt. So same effect you can get with the less wattage. That's why high frequency should be better buy. But that high frequency should be not more than 3.3 megahertz. Burn is equal to intensity of the current into time by area. Burn is equal to intensity of the current into time by area. This is the equation of electrosurgery. The amount of tissue burn depends upon intensity of the current. Intensity of the current means if I will use 100 watt, it will be more burn. If I will use 10 watt, it will be less burn. And there is a knob on the machine which we can use to increase or decrease the wattage. Isn't it? It is directly proportional. Time is also directly proportional. If you press intermittently like ten, stop, it will be less burn. But if you keep it pressed ten for a long time, it will be more burn. But area is a big problem. Area is inversely proportional. Area is inversely proportional. If area is more, burn is less. If area is less, burn is more, heat is more. And heat is more means coagulation is more. And it is better. This is a big problem. Intensity and time is compensating each other. Let us take an example. That if you have a machine to press the cloth, that is iron heating pressing machine. And it is not automatic. It is too hot. And your cloth is silk or polyester. And you have to press it. What should you do? You should move it fast. Very fast. If you move it fast, it won't give you the enough time to burn. But if you keep it and talk to someone which you see in movie, it will burn. And if other way, suppose it is less hot, and you have to press a jeans pant, then what you do? You move it slowly. So you are applying more time to it to work. Move it slowly. So the time and wattage is opposite to each other. And it is complementary to each other. And you can use it. It is very good. But area is the main culprit, and most of the complication happens due to area. So this we do mistake, and most of the people, they do mistake here. So what mistake we do, I am going to discuss to you. Let us assume that you are performing electrosurgery. and here is a gallbladder. This is a gallbladder. Here is a right and left hepatic duct, and this is the common hepatic duct, and this is CVT. Here is the CVT. And suddenly what happened, that you were performing very nicely, there was no issue, and there was cystic artery. Here is a cystic artery. And it started bleeding. And once it started bleeding, you are panicked. Everybody get panicked. And then you will get an instrument and you are holding a bunch of tissue that much. And you are burning this area completely. At that time, bleeding stops. After 1 week, patient will get jaundice. And patient come to you. Once you go to the ultrasound, you will get a stricture of the CVT. And you know why it happened. If you see here, here is the liver. This is the liver. And all the electron, which is formed over the cystic duct, it will immediately jump to the CVT. And from CVD it go to the common hepatic duct. From common hepatic duct it will go to the liver. From liver it will go to the latissimus dorsi. From latissimus dorsi it will go to the quadratus lumborum. From quadratus lumborum it will go to sauce. And here is the patient return plate. And then it will go to the patient plate. This is patient plate. This all is patient plate. And it will go to the patient plate. Now in this complete pathway of circuit, heat will be maximum where area is narrow. And during the pathway of circuit, once the current is traveling through the entire part of the body, you will get the burn there. Here, this is the burn. This is the point of burn. This is the burn. Burn will not be on the artery. Burn will be on the common hepatic duct, CVT. This is the burn. Because heat is maximum where area is narrow. Suppose anything happens to this room and all of us we want to evacuate this room. Where will be maximum resistance? On the door. The electron behaves just like human. We don't want resistance. Wherever we feel resistance, we are angry. So, we don't like, we don't liberty, full liberty. And if resistance someone will give, we are a little disturbed. So, during this passage, here will be the maximum narrow area and it will get burned. That's why whenever you want to coagulate any vessel, you can achieve 100% effect if you just hold the tip of the bladder. Like the yesterday when it was bleeding, one of our friend was asking, why didn't you do the proximal part? If you catch the proximal part, bleeding will not stop. Because heat will be produced less. If you hold less part, you will, hemostasis will be maximum achieved. Because heat will be more when you decrease the area. So this is one of the big mistakes which create remote injury. That we start holding a bunch of tissue due to excitement, due to panicking, and that creates the problem of the remote injury. This is called as remote injury. This is very, very important injury, which is called as remote injury. Remote injury is one of the big complications of the laparoscopy. It doesn't happen in open surgery. Because open surgery, our instruments are not that much fine. But here our instruments are fine and sometimes long cylindrical instrument and abdominal cavity convert into a cylinder. and that creates remote injury. So that's why whenever you want to minimize the heat, burn, intensity should be low or high? Low. Time should be more or less? Lesser. Area should be more or less? Less. Because less area will give you more heat where you want. If you give a more area, then heat will be where you don't want. Heat will be somewhere else, which is beyond your field of vision. And that is called as remote injury. Here we can see, surgeon is holding a hook and trying to cook the fallopian tube. But what mistake he is doing? His elevation angle is not correct, his port position is wrong, he is not only touching the tube, his naked part of the hook is touching the uterus also. So due to that, surface area increases. And due to this surface area increases, here is the burn. Fimbrial end of the tube was touching the bowel and bowel get perforated. After 2 days, patient come in the ICU with the peritonitis, and you will swear, I swear I didn't touch the bowel. I tell you, I did only tubectomy. I don't know how it happened. I never touched the bowel. And you are true, you have never touched the bowel, but your current has touched for you. Because it is a narrow area. The current, electric current is running through all the wire of this building. But why this bulb is only lighting? Because inside the bulb there is narrow filament. And due to that narrow filament, when current travels, it produces heat and light. So through the entire body, this area has a narrow area and it will burn there. Sometimes when you are doing cholecystectomy, if you use hook or you use energy, you will burn the CVT. Burn may happen at a place where you are attaching the patient return plate. Burn may happen on the thigh, arm, other places. When you are using patient return plate, you should must be very careful that you should apply in a well vascularized muscle mass. You should avoid vascular insufficiency, irregular body contour or brawny prominences. Here this is a small child. This is the abdomen of the child. He is wearing a t-shirt. This is buttock of the child. This is thigh. This is lateral view. An orthopedic surgeon has put the patient return plate on the lateral side on the condyle, bony prominence. And bony prominence get narrow area and it is burned. This is burned. So any bony prominence you should not apply. There are many type of patient return plate. First type of patient return plate is metal type. This is cheaper, but it is bad. It has a sharp edge. If you are applying, it will burn. Moreover, if you are applying on irregular body contour like hollow sacral curve and all, this sharp edge will touch the bony prominence and it will burn. So you should wrap it with a sponge and tetra and keep it moist with the saline. But this is almost obsolete. Other type is silicone type. This is silicone type. This is very good. Silicone type you can use, but silicone type you have to, it didn't have sharp edges. And good thing, even if you put the sacral permanente, it will take a shape of the body. And it increases the surface area of contact. And it will not harm. It is safer than the metal. But the safest is silver type, adhesive type. This has adhesive there. And this adhesive has 2 silver foil. And you can stick anywhere. You don't need gravity. You don't need the weight of the patient. Suppose this is the arm, even you can put on the arm also. And it is done. The silver type is attached. And it has a conductor. And it is adhesive. So it will make it sure that at least 100 square centimeter area should be in the contact. This is the burn due to the electrosurgery wrongly applied patient return plate. And as we know that electric burns are very bad. They take weeks to heal. They get sloughing and necrosis from the base. In this picture, a small patient return plate. This is electrode. Heat is produced both the places, here also and there also. In this picture, large patient return plate. Heat is only produced here. No heat there. So minimum 100 square centimeter area should be in the contact. 100 square, this 100 word looks big, but 100 square means 10 by 10 centimeter, means of a palm size, that much. At least that much area should be in the contact. 10 centimeter by 10 centimeter is 100 square centimeter. If less than that is attached, burn may happen at the place where you are attaching the patient return plate. So this is a big problem. Gynecologists, sometimes they do the surgery, and you will be surprised that electrosurgical injury in gynae practice is 4.3%. You will not do TLH if you will learn the rate of complication is 4.3%. How it happens, I will show you. Here is the uterus. And I will show you the video also, don't worry, of injury. Here is the uterus, and you are performing the surgery. This is the uterine artery, this is cervical branch, this is the ascending uterine branch, this is the main uterine. And everything was going fine, and suddenly you cut it, and ureter is going from here. This is ureter. Ureter will go and uterine is crossing it. And suddenly you cut it, this area, and then bleeding started. Once you have a bleeding, of course we get panicked, and here is the bleeding. And you go with the Maryland and you are cooking it here. Now, as soon as you cut it this area and you hold a bunch of tissue like this, then current has to go to the patient return plate. All the electron will jump to the ureter. Ureter is a very high conductor of electricity because it has a urine. And urine, as you know, has a normal saline. And normal saline is one of the best conductor of electricity. So ureter will invite all the current that come, I will take you where you want. And all the current jump to the ureter, from the ureter it will go to the source, from kidney, and from the kidney it will go to the source, and then it will go to the patient return plate. And this entire area of the travel, one peristalsis of ureter start and it will burn here. Peristalsis will start at this point, and it will burn somewhere else. So here is a peristalsis of this area, and it is burning here. This is the area, and this is the burn. Here. It is not where you are doing the cooking. It is burned somewhere else. And then you will cry like anything, your patient will get urotovaginal fistula, and you have a problem. And it is a big problem. And this problem can persist, and you will be surprised that in many situations you can have, here we can see this is a uterine bleeding. And the surgeon is panicked, it is retracting, it is impulse, it is going by trying to hold it anyhow with a bunch of tissue. It doesn't stop, it's still bleeding, it's still bleeding, it's still bleeding. Camera person is also get anxious, and he will try to bring the instrument nearer. Telescope should never go nearer the bleeder. And there is a spurt of the blood. It is going and it is retracting. And see, the tip of the telescope also gets swelled. And after that it will be cooked. It's still not stopped. And ultimately, do you know what happened? Ultimately, ureter was cut. And patient has, this is the, ultimately bleeding was anyhow stopped, this is uterus, this is cervix, this is bladder, and see here, ureter is cut. This is proximal end of ureter, this is distal end of ureter. Ureter is injured. So this type of injury, how to repair that injury, I will discuss later. If you cut the ureter, you can injure then and there. You can repair it, but I will discuss. So why it happened? This is the same reason of happening is that abrupt injury and you are trying to catch the bleeder. And once you try to catch the bleeder, you will have the complication. And this is the reason why it was injured here. So this is called as remote injury. Remote injury is a big killer. Please keep in mind that it becomes invisible. You will never see that. And it will happen anywhere else. So what is the message? How should you minimize the remote injury? How should you minimize the remote injury? First, yes? Yes, he is correct. That one way is don't use monopolar. So this is, he is correct, but we have to use it. Why? I will discuss later. Second reason, second way, but you are correct. Don't use, then it will not happen. Second? Pardon? Don't take a big bite. Yes, hold only precise bleeder point. Hold only precise bleeder point. Yes, third, decrease time. Never press more than 3 seconds in one go. 3 seconds in one go. Under vision. Don't run blindly to catch it. Yes, this way we can minimize the complication of remote injury. So it is absolutely correct. And that is why we should use. But question is, as he has told, we should not use monopolar, this is true. If you will use bipolar, there will be no remote injury. In bipolar, the current only travels through the jaw. Current never go to the other area. Current only travels in between the jaw. And there is one positive, other negative, and current will go in between the positive and negative. Do you know why? The scientists, they saw that if they are using the patient return plate nearer the surgery, like if you do breast surgery, axilla surgery, then apply patient return plate in the arm. Or in the groin surgery, thigh or waist. Then current will not go anywhere else. Locally, it will immediately go from here to here. So they thought that why not to bend the patient return plate itself inside the body of the patient. So in bipolar, there is no need of return electrode. Even if you will attach the return electrode, it doesn't work in bipolar. It doesn't work. Machine itself is disconnecting it. Suppose you are doing surgery and in monopolar mode, you forgot to put the patient return plate, do you know what will happen? Your machine will start giving fault alarm, alarm and light. Fault alarm. I will show you all the machine also. But if you are using the bipolar, it will not give you alarm. If it is not attached, patient return plate is not attached, it doesn't give you any alarm. Because it is not required. And even if you attach, it doesn't work. So this is very good energy source, bipolar. And bipolar, if you will use it, most of the complication of the remote injury can be minimized. Some people, they say that bipolar behaves like a happily married couple and monopolar behaves like a restless, unfaithful bachelor. Because if they are not honest, unfaithful bachelor, they will try to find out the area of least resistance. Wherever least resistance is there, they will try. But if you are happily married couple, then positive is taking care of negative, negative is taking care of all, accountable. You have to give each and every minute. And positive current only travel in between positive and negative. So there is no remote injury, less chances are there. Isn't it? So this is happily married couple, that is bipolar. And no remote injury. Current only travel in between the jaw. It is not traveling anywhere else. But in monopolar, anywhere if there is area of least resistance, then it will try to deviate to that area. The question is, then why should not we throw the bipolar out of my OT? What is the need of monopolar? I should throw out of my OT. Bipolar has a lot of problems. One of the problems of the bipolar is, every instrument cannot be bipolar. Like every animal cannot marry. They don't marry. Every instrument cannot be bipolar. You have to especially program it. Like Roby dissector, bipolar forceps. Storch has made bipolar seizures at one time. Do you know what is there in these seizures? One jaw is made up of plastic. Only tip is metal. And another jaw is pure metal. So this metal and plastic will keep them apart. Because if there is a joint there, it will get short-circuited. Both metal, then current will go metal to metal. And current will not go to the tissue. So bipolars are only few instruments are bipolar available in the market. And those instruments I am going to demonstrate to you. This is the Roby dissector, this is bipolar. How you will know? It has a yellow plastic tip here. Roby dissector. On the back you have a two pole. Two poles are there. This is bipolar. Another bipolar instrument you have is the bipolar forceps. This is not insulated from outside, this is insulated from inside. If you see very carefully, there is a plastic insulation. Can you see that? Here. This part is naked. This is metal. But here it is covered by plastic. This is a plastic insulation there. This is also bipolar forceps. And it is, both the instruments are separately insulated. Did you see the plastic here? It's a plastic coating. This is also plastic coating. I can show you, this is a plastic seal. And it is metal to metal inside. On the back also you have two. Then you have the bipolar hook. This is bipolar hook here. If you see, they have made a silicone gap in between. There is an insulation plate in between two metal. On the back there is a positive negative, two electrodes. This is bipolar hook. This is bipolar grasper. This is made up of plastic, so it will keep metal to metal away. And inside there are two wires. And here you cannot dismantle it, you cannot open it. And remember, in any instrument which you cannot dismantle, they give you one attachment here. Do you know what is this for? Yes, flushing it, to clean it. So time to time after surgery, in the syringe you should put a saline and with the detergent, and then you put it and flush it out. And then put in the cytex. Because here you cannot dismantle, there is no joint, it is sealed. Both are sealed, you cannot open it. Because if you open it, the wires are there, it will twist it and it will break. And it is welded on the back. So this is bipolar grasper. And these are the only instrument available anywhere in the world with the bipolar technology. So bipolar has limited instrument. And this is why bipolar cannot be used everywhere. So this is one of the first problems. What is that problem? That bipolar doesn't have all the instrument possibility. You cannot have needle of the bipolar. You cannot have seizures of the bipolar. You cannot have the knife with the bipolar. Not possible. Monopolar, any instrument can be converted into monopolar. Another drawback of the monopolar is that it has more collateral damage for same wattage of current. Let us assume that this is the tissue. Here is the tissue. And you are using bipolar. This is bipolar. And if you, this is positive, this is negative in the bipolar. And if you use the current, current travel in between the jaw. In between the jaw, temperature is 300 degrees centigrade. Approximately 3 millimeter lateral, temperature is 200 degrees centigrade. Approximately 5 millimeter lateral, temperature is 100 degrees centigrade. And approximately 6 millimeter lateral, temperature is 55 degrees centigrade. And as we know, up to 55 degree, tissue is dead. This is called as collateral damage. Collateral damage is different from remote injury. Remote injury is the injury which happens anywhere in the body in narrow area. And remote injury can only be done by what? Remote injury can only be done by the monopolar. But collateral damage is lateral spread of heat. Suppose you will take a candle and you take a pin in your hand and put the tip of the pin over the candle and heat for a few minutes, your candle heat will reach to your finger and you will drop the pin. But immediately nothing happens. But within few seconds, you will drop it. So if you use 100 watt current for 3 seconds, then collateral damage is 6 millimeter. Whereas in monopolar, it is only 2 to 3 millimeter. In monopolar, collateral damage is less. For same wattage and same in timing, it is less. If you use 100 watt for 3 seconds in monopolar, it will be only 2 millimeter. Question is why? In monopolar, what is the advantage? That this is the tissue. And one pole is here, this is one pole, and another pole is here, this is another pole. This is return electrode, and this is called as active electrode, this is active electrode. And current has to go towards the return electrode, it is not in between the jaw. So collateral damage is less because direction of the flow is towards the electrode. Just like a husband and wife before the marriage, they fight less because you are away from each other. You only WhatsApp, Facebook or phone. But after marriage, collateral damage is more in the family. After marriage, husband and wife, they fight more. Reason being, you are too nearer to each other always. You don't give a space to your partner. And you are too near always. So for a small thing also, there may be big fight. In the morning, she will make a breakfast for you. And if you don't like it, you will say, what is rubbish every day? I am bored eating it. What is nonsense you are doing it? She will say, I am not your slave. I am also a doctor. And what is this? This is the way to speak. You were not like that before the marriage. I cannot tolerate. Enough is enough. This is last warning I am giving you. Husband, what is last warning? Every day you are doing the same. Fight start. By the evening you have a big fight. Big fight, and maybe it may turn in big problem. This is what collateral damage. Collateral damage is due to lateral spread of the heat going each other and it make a big heat. And it go collateral. Collateral nearby, like your other family members are also disturbed. Your family is disturbed due to your fight. This is collateral. Even neighbors are disturbed. They will say that now they will start fighting, we cannot sleep. So, this is the problem of the bipolar. But this collateral damage is good because it is under your control. If someone you will tell that bipolar has more collateral damage than monopolar, they will say no. Who has told you this? You will say Dr. Mishra, and you will say he is like that only. It is not good. He is telling whatever he wants to tell. Don't believe it. And actually he is correct. Bipolar has less collateral damage than monopolar. Do you know why? Because you tell him only half sentence. Bipolar has twice to thrice more collateral damage than monopolar if same wattage and same timing you will use as monopolar. But if you want to decrease the collateral damage of bipolar, you can do it by decreasing the intensity and decreasing the timing. Like if you will tell someone, husband, wife, they fight more. All husband, wife, they don't fight. Many of them, they have a very happy life. Question is why? Because their intensity is low and they are intermittent. If you don't fight to your spouse in your life, if you want a happy marriage life, just remember two things. One thing is keep intensity low and intermittent. If you don't like the breakfast, you tell that, do you know this breakfast, I don't know why, it doesn't look good. And if she will say that, I don't have a time, I'm not your slave, don't react, don't speak, don't immediately counter. Wait for 15 minutes and then say, you try, you will definitely make it better than this. Then she will not fight. So she will say that he is maybe telling true. So intensity low and intermittent. So I am using 100 watt for 3 seconds. What I will do, that I will use 30 watt for 1 second. And then my collateral damage will be only 2 millimeters. Very good. This is the advantage. That bipolar, even it is used by neurosurgeons, and to prevent collateral damage, what they do, they use very less watt, 1 or 2 watt, and for a fraction of second, and then it is not giving much collateral. You don't give time to get collateral damage. If you keep on continuously hitting the same rope, then it will be a problem. So why I got wrong? Because you told your teacher that Dr. Mishra was telling that bipolar has more collateral damage than monopolar. You don't have to tell this. You have to tell that I have told you that bipolar has more collateral damage than the monopolar if same wattage and same intensity which you are using for monopolar will be applied on the bipolar also. Because all the other parameters should be standard. Then it has more. But generally, what the company they do, that they gave the modulated current. Whenever you switch the bipolar, automatically they decrease the intensity of the machine. And then you have collateral, but still collateral damage is more. But you can minimize it by decreasing the time. So never ever press than 3 seconds in one go. 1 second is 101. So 101, 101, 101 is 3 seconds. And if you will use that, your collateral damage can be minimized. So this is second drawback of the bipolar. First drawback of the bipolar was, every instrument is not bipolar. Second drawback is, for same wattage, same timing, it has more collateral damage. Third drawback of the bipolar, it doesn't cut. It only coagulates. Bipolar doesn't cut. You have to cut physically after coagulation. Only one bipolar cut, that is PK energy, plasma kinetic energy, that is very expensive bipolar, can cut. But normal bipolar of up to 10 lakh rupees doesn't cut. So you have to coagulate and then cut with the scissors. Or coagulate or cut with the inbuilt blade. There is a blade that is tripolar, or ligature is also bipolar, it has a blade. But by default, bipolar its own doesn't cut, except PK energy. So this is also one of the drawbacks. Whereas, monopolar will cut also, coagulate also, and it can be used for other purposes also. So this is the another drawback of the bipolar. That's why we don't use, we have to use monopolar. Because without monopolar, you cannot think of performing the surgery. Like suppose you have to do ovarian drilling. You need monopolar. You want colpotomy to cut the vaginal fornix. You need monopolar. You want to separate the gallbladder from liver. You have to use monopolar. Bipolar will not separate the gallbladder from the liver. Isn't it? You have to do myomectomy to cut the serous layer of myoma, to enucleate the myoma from uterus. You have to use monopolar to cut the muscle. There is no way. Either you use monopolar or you use some other energy sources. But current you cannot use except monopolar, anything else. In bipolar, here this is appendix surgery. You can make a small window in the major appendix. After that, you can use this bipolar and coagulate. And you can see the bubble. This is the bubble coming. And again, intermittent, not more than 3 seconds in one go. Ten, stop. Ten, stop. Ten, stop. Ten, stop. Ten, stop. And then cut with the scissors. This is how you have to use bipolar. Because it only coagulates, it doesn't cut. But you don't need insulation. You don't need to remove the ornament necklaces of the patient. You don't need to keep the patient return plate. And you don't need to keep the OT table insulated. Because in bipolar, remote injury is not there. Current only go in between the jaw. And that way you are safe. So that's why even if the timing, instrument timing increases, you apply first bipolar and then bring seizures, it is safe because there is no remote injury. This is the waveform setting of electrocautery. Pure cut, pure coagulation and blend. What is pure cut? Pure cut is a high frequency, low voltage current. Pure cut we do by yellow paddle. So when, suppose you bought a electrosurgical generator from 1 kilohertz to 900 kilohertz, suppose this is my machine, then when you press yellow, it will give you 900 kilohertz, means maximum frequency available. That is 100% on. And what will happen? Cell will fracture. Because that much vibration of the ions, cell membrane cannot tolerate. And cytoplasm evaporized. And that is what we sell cut. What is cut? Giving away is cut. When you put a knife, sharp of the knife will touch the tissue. Tissue cannot tolerate, it will give away. It will fracture. Fracturing of the tissue by the sharp edge of the knife is called cut. And same way here, fracturing of the tissue by high frequency electron creates cut. But the tissue which is uncut is healthy. It is very nice, it is healthy. This is pure cut. Now pure coagulation. Pure coagulation is very high voltage and very low frequency current. So it has one big spike and plateau. Big spike and plateau. Only 6% of the frequency of the machine is used, 94% is not used, which is off. So if you are using 100 kilohertz to suppose 900 kilohertz machine, when you press blue, it will give you lowest frequency. So what will happen? A spike and plateau. A spike and plateau. There is no turbulence. Turbulence means uncontrolled movement. And due to this plateau movement, this is low frequency, heat of the tissue increases. It isn't fracture. And once heat of the tissue increases, At 55 degrees centigrade, it will denature the protein. And protein coagulates. Then coagulated protein shrink. And once the coagulated protein will shrink, the lumen of the vessel will shrink. Then temperature go further to 80 degrees centigrade. And at 80 degrees centigrade, elastin and collagen, these are the two chemicals in the tissue, those elastin and collagen will melt and fuse together. And that will give us the hemostasis. If suppose accidentally someone will press the yellow paddle during holding a tip of the vessel, what will happen? It will be fractured and you have more bleeding. Or someone has to cut and it will start coagulation, what will happen? It will stick, it will join, it will not cut, it will burn. Some surgeons have a bad habit that in laparotomy, not in laparoscopy, they cut the muscles and rectus with the coagulation current. And do you know what argument they give? They give the argument less bleeding. But do you know they have more infection rate and hypertrophic scar? Because margins of those cut end has a burned tissue, burned collagen and coagulated burned protein. And when you suture it, it's sutured by secondary intention, not by primary intention, and you have the bad healing. Healing is delayed. So if you want to cut with the coagulation, you should use blend mode. Company is giving you that don't use coagulation. I am giving you the current which you want. And blend is a mixture of cutting and coagulation, which has 50% frequency of cut, 50% of cut coagulation. Blend 1 is more towards the cut, blend 3 is more towards the coagulation. So now I have a question for you. If you have to do salpingotomy in unruptured ectopic pregnancy, which current you should use? Pure cut or blend cut or coagulation? Pure cut. Why? Because you need margins healthy. If you use blend cut or coagulation, margin will be burnt tissue and there will be a stricture and it will not unite. If you want to do pyeloplasty, you should use pure cut. If you want ureteric lithotomy, you should use pure cut. If you want bowel perforation to do the side-to-side anastomosis in gastric bypass, you should use pure cut. If you want to do myomectomy, to cut the muscle, to remove the myoma, you should use pure cut or blend cut? Blend cut. Very good. If you use pure cut, you will have a lot of bleeding from muscle margin. And for cutting muscle, and in that much deep in the uterus, if little stricture happens, it doesn't matter much. But in the tube, little stricture will create the tubal blockage. If you want to do colpotomy, you should use pure cut or blend cut? Blend cut. So it is there in the machine and you are not using, you are cutting pure cut, you have a bleeding. So you should use blend cut. If you use blend cut for colpotomy, the margins of the cut wound of the vagina will not bleed. So this is important to keep in mind that cut is of two types, one is pure cut, other is blend cut. Now exactly same way, coagulation is also of two types. One is fulguration, another is desiccation. What is fulguration? It is also called as a spray mode, and it is a coagulation current from some distance. Whenever you want less depth of injury, more width of injury, you should use a spray mode. This is depth of injury is 1/6 less, width of injury is more. Just like if you want to put a perfume on your body, you are taking a spray and you are keeping. You are not putting on your nose and then pressing. You put in the nose the spray and then press, your mucosa will burn. You will cry like anything. So you need not injury, you need just a coating. So fulguration mode is for oozers. Oozers, like the bed of the endometriosis is oozing, the liver bed after cholecystectomy is bleeding. Partial nephrectomy you are doing and the remaining kidney is oozing. Then you will do fulguration. This is fulguration. This is endometriosis. And this fulguration is burning the... Even if you are in cul-de-sac, even if you are over the rectum, even if you are over the ureter, it is safe. Because depth of injury will be less, width will be wider. Like painting the car, they don't touch the car and spray, they keep some distance. So that a thin film of paint will cover your car. Or if you are painting your box or wall, you are maintaining a distance. If you touch the wall and then spray, all the paint will drop down. So this is fulguration. A spatula is the best instrument to do fulguration. Because back of a spatula is a large area which gives you a spray more. And area will be covered more. Endometriosis, you need fulguration. Cholecystectomy, you need fulguration. Bowels should be avoided, but superficially you can do. Now desiccation. Desiccation means, it is electrosurgical desiccation means coagulation current with firm contact. In fulguration, direct contact should be avoided. You need to have a distance. But in desiccation, you have to give firm contact. No. Once you change the machine to the fulguration mode, the voltage becomes so high that it starts jumping in air also. You don't need to touch. Once, if you should just brush it. Just brush it. Just touch the blood, don't touch the tissue. And it works. If fulguration, you press and then you do, it is desiccation. Desiccation is coagulation current with firm contact. And now there is another drawback of the bipolar. What was the first drawback of the bipolar? Yes, not all the instruments do. Second drawback? Collateral damage is more for same wattage and same intensity. Not half a sentence. Please. Other damage? It doesn't cut. And another damage, another drawback I will tell you, bipolar only desiccates. It doesn't fulgurate also. You go with the bipolar near the tissue, it doesn't have attraction. Tissue will say, you are already married, why you are coming here? And that also coming with the wife. This is enough. They don't attract the electron. Monopolar, in monopolar, one pole is your electrode and another pole is what? Body. Why? Body is attached with the patient return plate. So body is attracting the electron and monopolar spatula is discharging the electron. But in bipolar, without touching, it doesn't work. Current can never jump on the tissue, it only jumps in between the jaw. So this is the other drawback of bipolar. Bipolar cannot cut, bipolar cannot blend, and bipolar cannot fulgurate also. It only desiccates. So desiccation of the bipolar seals. During desiccation will be done by both, bipolar and monopolar. In fact, monopolar will do all. Monopolar pure cut, blend cut, fulguration, desiccation, and desiccation, water content of the tissue go out, protein will denature and it will touch each other and coagulated protein shrinks and melted elastin and collagen will seal. And it is called as fused lumen. Lumen is fused, hemostasis is achieved, bleeding is stopped. So this is called desiccation, and desiccation seals. If you want to seal anything, you have to do desiccation. Now, variables impacting tissue effect. I can, right now we are in the half of the lecture. I can see some of your face looking little tired. If you want, I can give you 2 minute break. It is up to you. You want? Get a coffee and come. I will wait here for you.